What's happening, Blades? Unbelievable results yesterday. 3 points for the Blades, no points for the Boro. Oh my God. It couldn't have gone any better with results yesterday. I'm not going to go as far as saying I knew it, because I didn't, but I was trying to be positive. I thought we could beat Watford. I thought we would beat Watford. I'm pretty sure I said that. And I wasn't convinced that Boro would get anything at West Brom. I think we've got enough to beat Watford. I think we will beat Watford. I think this weekend, as the title says, we're going again. This is the one where we turn it round. And I'm also not convinced, although I thought they were quite poor against Watford, I'm not convinced West Brom get turned over by Boro. I had to chuck that in. I'm still buzzing now. Came out at ground feeling elated yesterday because we knew that we were trying to get scores up, which is always dangerous anyway, but we knew that West Brom were winning 2-0 from 10 minutes in. I mean, you can never count Boro out, can you? We've seen them in up close. We know how dangerous they can be on the attack. You know how much I love Cameron Archer. I thought there's still a chance they'd pull it back. And obviously, we were 0-0 for a long time. But I have to say, yesterday, I mean, I've seen some mixed reviews with performance. A lot of people saying it were a scrappy game and it wasn't full of quality. I mean, I'm not saying quality levels were up there, but I thought it were a great game. Really enjoyed it. And I don't often enjoy games. It's more something I have to get through. And as dangerous as they were on break and as close as they got to scoring, for some reason, I just felt like yesterday were going to be our day. And it proved to be. And how good is that feeling? How good does that feel? And this isn't a case of, you know, so stick it to them that said we'd thrown it away, because it's understandable why people were worried and thought we might have thrown it away. We're one fan base end of day, and the one thing we need to do is try and stick together. Some will be nervous, some will be overconfident. We're all going to have different opinions on how it's going, whether Ecky's right man to do it, because I saw some doubts about him earlier. You know, and I just think we're now 7 points clear of third place. We're a game in hand. But, and it's a big but, it's one that's notable and worth mentioning, we have got a much tougher running than Boro over the next 6 or 7 games. So we have to keep everything in check. We have to be realistic. We're going to Blackburn next in the league. Obviously, I know we've got Tottenham midweek. But we're going to Blackburn next in the league. They've won 3 on spin. So if we think, just because I think we're a better team than Blackburn, but it's certainly not just going to be one you turn up to and turn them over. There's still a long way to go. There's 12 games left for Boro, 13 for us. There's a lot of points to play for. But back to the game yesterday, I watched Nick's review of the game on Sheffield United Way, match reaction. I don't usually get back in time to jump on and have me say in his live chat, but I try and watch it afterwards or whenever I can. And we normally agree on an awful lot of things, but there were a couple of bits that I didn't think were as I saw it anyway, which don't make me right, don't make him right. He said that he thought Bogle had a fantastic game. I mean, I hadn't seen game back, but I didn't think he did. I thought Bogle was one of the few to have an average game. And thankfully, it didn't cost us, but I thought he was giving a few sloppy passes away. Nick rightly mentioned a tackle that he should have definitely been booked for, and he weren't, which was crazy considering where he booked an L. Nick also said that he thought Watford's defence were poor. I thought they were good. I thought they were really strong. And he were leaning towards the fact that we know they've got such a strong attack, and they have, no doubt about it. That front four is frightening with the pace that they break at and things, but they just couldn't finish their dinner yesterday, could they? I mean, Keenan Davis, we've seen him come to Bramall Lane and cause us absolute nightmares. When he came with Forest last year, he was the one player that I would say, coming into this season, I'd be happy to never see him visit Bramall Lane again in an opposition shirt, because I thought he were that good. But he's not a finisher. He can do everything. everything apart from finish. Always a threat, though. Always a threat. Good ball carrier. Great feet for a big man. He's like a battering ram running with ball at his feet. Very quick for a big lad. So, yeah, I thought special mention to John Fleck, who came back in after a couple of months out. I know he played for 23s and set up the winning goal, essentially, but I thought it was superb today. Absolutely superb. Like he'd not missed a beat. And we've needed that. We've needed him in engine room. And he just balances us out nicely, I think. Really strong addition. And it harsh on Tommy Doyle, who I thought looked very good when he came on as well. Very nearly scored from outside at box, and Osborne then just not quite getting it with follow-up. Thought Jackie Longthrow were very strong again. I mean, he's not the most cultured of players, which we know, but he's a proper Blades player, isn't he, really? I mean, all blood and thunder, puts his head in, does exactly what you want him to do, strong tackles. I mean, I wouldn't go so far to say as he's turned me quite yet to being a follower. But we can't ask much more. I think the best way to say it is probably he's got limited ability and championships probably his level, but he can't give us any more. He can't push himself any more than he has been doing. And his performances recently have been very, very good. I were pushing for Clark to come back in today. And yeah, I don't think Robinson's played well against Boro or Millwall. But prior to that, I think he's been very good. And obviously, Ollie Mack is the other one I want to shout out. Thought he had another strong, really strong performance. He tired towards the end, which sort of lessened his effectiveness. And the one thing I will say, and this is, I hate to sort of bring what might be perceived as a negative. It's just that I try and work it out sometimes and I can't always do it. So when McBurney tires and we are 1-0 up and you think, we could do with bringing him off here, but I know Ecky likes to keep him on for defensive headers because he's very good in both boxes. He won everything in air today. He wants to keep him on, but he's knackered. And, you know, we've got big games coming up. We need to make sure he's right. So he brings Billy on. And now, listen, Billy played well when he came on, I thought. This is not against Billy. I don't want to sort of have any misconceptions about that because my question is more about the tactical nous of Ecky. And look, we've got 3 points. It's gone our way. I'm not complaining at all. And it's easy to do this in hindsight. And it's maybe putting a negative slant on it. But the one thing I would question is, when there's 10 minutes to go, we need this win. It's so important. Why is he not bringing on Basham for McBurney? And dropping Basham maybe just in front at defence and having just solidifying that middle at park as like a defensive midfielder, if you like, even behind Norwood, and shoring it up and just having Ndiaye as an outlet, or even Jebo, bringing Jebo on for Ndiaye, whatever it might be, just to stretch the game. But that keeps your height, that keeps your reasonably strong aerial ability. In Bash, it sort of provides more of a screen when you know that they're going to be pushing. But instead, we kept the same shape, which when they then have the impetus to throw everybody forward, it's like the Alamo, isn't it? They just keep, and you know it's going to be. And that last minute, last few seconds in box, wow. Just wow. How did that stay out? We talk about riding your luck, but I thought we'd earned it. I thought we were a better team in first half, just. And I thought we were comfortably a better team in second half, although they always look dangerous on break. So, fantastic result for us yesterday. Can't say any other. Really, really pleased with how it turned out. And here's how the table looks now, which is an awful lot better than it did this time a few days ago. So, fantastic front Blades, and the character and effort that they showed. Really, really strong performance. Really strong and absolutely delighted. It's amazing, isn't it, how it can alter your mood for the whole weekend and things like that. So chuffed to bits, absolutely chuffed to bits with that result. I've just about finalised my scout them out bits. I've been doing my due diligence and my research, if you like. So that'll be coming soon. As I've said, I've got a planned video with Nick on Sheffield United Way in terms of goalkeepers. And obviously, one to start with is usually goalkeepers if you're going to build your team. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a Championship team and I'm going to do a Premier League team. And this is what I think Sheffield United should do, either in the summer or whatever it might be, to prepare for whatever league we're going to be in. But I'm going to hold until Nick wants to release that video on Sheffield United Way, just out of respect for what we're going to be doing on his channel as well, because I'd agreed to that before. I'd said I was going to do this. So it's just about done. It's all planned. And I'll get them out to you as soon as we get our video out on Sheffield United Way. So stay tuned. I'm going to finish on a feature we haven't done for a little while. This is Off the Pitch. So just a couple of bits to talk about here today. So I just want to announce that me and Ollie McBurney are now best friends. He replied to my tweet, which means we're best friends now. So I'd just like to dedicate this video to my new best friend, Ollie McBurney. Well done yesterday, mate, and hope you recover from your broken finger soon. just an idiot. The main news, and I don't want to get too excited by this because there's oh so many different layers to it. Jack O'Connell is back on the grass, as they say. But he's back running, and it's light running. I have to temper this with sort of manage people's expectations and my own. But he's back on the grass, he's back running, doing light running. They're putting no pressure on him, Ecky says. And he's been further along than this before and had a setback. So let's not all get super excited straight away, because even if it gets to the point where he's knocking a ball around again, Will he ever get to the levels that he was previously? So the first question is, can he come back? And the second question will be, if he does, what level will he be at? So loads of... We're just wishing him well, aren't we? Because what a horrific thing to happen to such a fantastic player and person. Everything you see about him is he's such a nice kid. And you just wish him well. So is keeping everything crossed for Jack O'Connell. We optimistically look forward to a further update from you, Jock. And just before I go, since we had a break from it last time, I'm going to give you a little cheeky nudge to ask those of you that aren't subscribed to please do so. Not pandering, but just give this a watch. So if you'd like to subscribe and you'd like to get me over the 800 barrier and watch my new 900 target video, which I've already done, which I'm still not sure on, but it made me laugh, then please do so. Absolutely over the moon with yesterday's result. Absolutely delighted. I can't stop smiling, and it's ridiculous because it's football, isn't it? But it's mad how it affects us. I hope you guys have been picked up too by the result, and it sort of changes your perspective on how things are, because it feels like it's a real shot in the arm of confidence. I mean, do you dare to imagine that, you know, say us and Boro get the same result next game, the next game is Reading's game in hand. Imagine if we beat Reading and we go 10 points clear. And then they've got 11 games to play and we've got at least a 3-game cushion on them. So we only have to win 8, and that's if they win them all. Oh, just I can't. Anyway, enjoy the rest of your weekend. Bring on Tottenham. I don't know whether I'll do a preview for Tottenham, but spoiler alert, my team is put your reserves out. Let Anel play because he's now suspended for the next two league games. Whether I do or I don't. Come on, you 7-point clear gaming and red and white wizards, and up the blade.